position of the Employment Minister, Mr. Robert Carr, was one of pure and unadulterated relief.
Above all, I'm delighted that I think we've at last reached the end of this very difficult and stubborn dispute that has caused a lot.
Darling, there is a bell.
Morning, Camilla.
I thought Andrew was coming.
Oh, we just had a bloody great row and he stormed off back to his flat. Good riddance.
Oh, you love it really, don't you?
What do I mean him?
Well, he's not boring, darling, is he? Let's face it. Anyway, he'll be at the polo. Oh,
no, you can't have him, darling. Not possible.
Why the hell not?
He's engaged. Sorry. Now he's free. What about him?
That would make Andrew jealous, wouldn't it?
Certainly bloody would, darling. The Prince of bloody Wales. I'd go for it if I were you.
Hello, darling. Hello. What happened this morning? Am I forgiven? Are you friends again? Why don't I see you later? Say Annabelle's? 11?
Bye. Really? I wonder why you bother with him. You?
I think you did jolly well.
That's a fine looking animal, sir.
My name's Camilla Shand. Very pleased to meet you.
Did you know that the first proper game of polo played in this country was in Hounslow in 1869? I mean, somehow, Hounslow.
How wonderful to have a university education.
The 10th Hussars won by 3-2.
Are you good at crosswords too? Sir.
I need to call me sir. My name is Charles.
Well, can I be awfully presumptuous then, Charles? I'm desperate for a cigarette.
Oh, I don't indulge, I'm afraid.
No, I meant...
But there are plenty of chaps here who do, so you can get yourself a cigarette. I shan't be in the least offended.
No, I meant, do you mind if I smoke? In front of you, I mean.
Good heavens, no. Half the family smokes. Princess Margaret passed away like a chimney. What other vices do you have? I didn't mean... I'm bloody awful at this sort of thing.
What sort of thing's that?
Well, I had it in mind to ask you out. Now, I'd understand if you'd rather not. I mean, if I were in your shoes, I don't think I'd want to go out with someone like me. There's more bother than it's worth. Not that there is anyone else like me, unfortunately. That's the trouble.
But you're only asking me out, Charles. What's the big deal?
She's a lady.
Anne. What a coincidence. I met your sweet brother just a few hours back. I've never met him before. Isn't that odd?
Not too much of a disappointment, I hope.
Quite the contrary.
Anyway, I've got to go.
Don't rush off on my account.
I'm not.
Good night.
Well, what would you like, darling?
I'd like you to stay away from ex-shags, darling, if that's all right with you.
How long have you been hunting?
3 months.
Done any jumping before that?
No, never.
Yourself. What were you trying to do? Impress me?
There's no way to talk to me. Oh. I've never been very good at sport. There's something about riding really fast and taking the high offensive. I can't imagine why I didn't take it up earlier.
You won't be doing it for much longer if you go for every bloody hedge and ditch like that. You'll be dead or in a wheelchair.
But that's the thing, isn't it? The risk of it. Focuses the mind wonderfully. It's not fun worrying about everything else.
Personally, I find a large gin and tonic has much the same effect.
I hear you're saying Camilla Shand.
Don't do that.
As a matter of fact, Andrew.
What do you mean?
Nothing. Just said they were stationing him abroad. Germany or somewhere. Can't help wondering how you'll cope.
I shall cope perfectly well, thank you. It was just a little fling, that's all.
How you'll cope with Camilla, I can't imagine.
Well, it's nothing serious. We've been riding, that's all.
Yes. Andrew tells me Camilla rides very well.
I believe it's from Prince Philip, sir. Would you like me to wait for a reply, sir?
No.
Forgive me, sir, but I was given to understand that His Royal Highness expected a reply.
If and when I need you to take a reply, I'll summon you. Otherwise, assume not.
Of course, sir.
This is a first, Charles.
Bringing one chap home and having another one waiting outside. Could get used to this.
Don't embarrass him, please.
Sorry. Not used to detect.
Sorry. Bit of a mess.
No, it's charming. Really, I mean it.
Well, you're going to find out I'm a slut soon enough, I suppose.
Exactly.
You sure you don't want a brandy?
No, thank you. I have to fly an aeroplane tomorrow. It wouldn't do if I had a hangover.
Why do you have to fly an aeroplane? How absolutely terrifying.
Actually, I rather like it. Great sense of freedom on one's own in the cockpit. Not that that's why I'm doing it.
So why are you?
Well, because I'm the Prince of Wales and one day I'll be king. And Mama and Father and Uncle Dickie have mapped out my future for me, especially Father. First the RAF and then the Navy. If I might say that everything that happens to me is a preparation.
Don't you dread it, though? The whole thing?
Thank you. Well, one's destiny, isn't it? Dreadfully embarrassing word, I know. Only Mama and I really know what it feels like. We don't talk about it, but, well, it's a sort of thing between us. I think she knows I'd never let her down. Am I boring you? Sorry, I should leave.
No, no, please. Sit down. You're sweet. Very sweet boy. Am I allowed to say that?
I'd really rather you didn't.
So, what happens, say, if... I mean, how long does that chappie have to stay outside?
As long as I'm in here.
So, what do we do? Send out food and drink at regular intervals? Or do they bring in supplies from the palace? I suppose you've had all these jokes before.
Well, most people are a little more circumspect.
Circumspect?
One gets very used to being called sir.
But you told me not to.
No, and I didn't.
Look, I do know about royal bloody protocol, Charles. Do you know who my grandmother was? My great-grandmother, actually. She was your great-great-grandfather's mistress, Charles. And do you know what she said her job was? She said, my job is to curtsy to the king first, then jump into bed with him.
Did she really?
Yes, she did.
Are you by any chance saying what I think you're saying?
Put it this way, Charles. I'm buggered if I'm curtsying.
Thank you for having us down, Uncle Dickie.
She's good fun. I like her. Bring her here whenever you want.
Much better than all those awful flat-chested girls you see all over the place nowadays. What's her name? Twiggy.
God in heaven.
Now, you've got yourself a real woman there. Experienced. Got a bit of meat on her. Hmm? Damn good fun in bed, too, I bet. Come on, don't be so coy, huh?
I'm really very fond of her.
Of course you are. Perfect mistress material.
When I say that I'm fond of her, what I mean to say is that I'm extremely fond of her.
Keep yourself a moving target, Charles. Don't think about settling down now. Well, don't even consider it till you're 30. Heaven knows you're going to have time enough to be serious. Just sow your wild oats. You're the luckiest young man alive. You've got millions. You're the Prince of Wales. Good God, you can screw any girl you bloody want. Enjoy it.
Uncle Dickie thinks you're terrific.
Why do you call him Uncle? He's your father's uncle.
Oh, I used to call him Grandpapa. That's how I think of him, really. My honorary grandfather. He's always been there for me. Always managed to make time for me. And of course, Mama and Father are fearfully busy. Not their fault. I know this is absurd. And we've hardly known each other, but it doesn't feel like that, does it? Probably the last thing you want to hear, but I've got to ask. Would you ever consider marrying me?
Oh, God, no. Oh, Christ. Look, don't get me wrong, Charles. I'm fearfully fond of you. I have no desire whatsoever to be queen. I mean, living your life in a bloody goldfish bowl. Who in their right mind would want that?
I thought some girls were rather keen on the idea.
Look, why don't we just enjoy ourselves, Charles? Have some fun.
Not sure how good I am at fun.
Don't worry. I'm good enough for both of us.
Yes, you are.
Do try not to look so bloody depressed about it. That's what you like about me, you idiot. By the way, did you know I'm not a virgin, Charles? It's true, I'm afraid. It's another reason I could never be queen.
Good grief. No.
Afraid so.
Unhand me then, Gladys.
Who?
Gladys. Aren't you filthy, Gladys?
I'm not filthy. Or Gladys. If you're not nice to me, I'll call President Fred and he'll have you deaded, he will.
You didn't tell me you were a Goons fan.
You didn't ask. You should have done. You naughty, naughty boy.
Now look here, stop
you
that.
You should have done.
Stop that.
Oh,
no.
President Fred, I can't. I can't.
You don't think you're in the tiniest danger of getting out of your depth, do you, darling?
I've no idea what you're talking about.
And how's it stand with Andrew? I imagine he's heard all about Charles by now.
I imagine he must have done. Yes. So lots of adoring, desperate letters from Germany, then?
Not quite his style, adoring letters. Or desperate, for that matter.
No, of course not. Henry would be just the same.
You know, Charles isn't like that at all. A bit solemn and pompous at times, but mostly... Well, I must say, it's terribly nice to be with a chap who's so open about things.
Christ, what do you mean, open?
I don't know. Sort of tells you what he feels. And who really seems to need one somehow.
A bedded can't be wedded, Charles. You know that as well as I do. The last thing the royal family needs is a princess with a past. She's got to be pure and chaste. A perfect fantasy up there on her pedestal.
Do you not think finding a girl who's pure and chaste is a little tricky nowadays? In fact, downright bloody impossible, I'd say.
Well, not all young girls are like your Cambridge bloody intellectuals, you know. All you've got to do is to find a sweet-charactered girl before some other chap gets his hands on her. And when the time comes, we'll all be there to help you.
We?
Your father and I are agreed that at present your priority is the Navy. It's an excellent training. And it'll prepare you in so many ways for your future.
I'm aware of my duty, Uncle. And despite what my father says, I'm not a shirker. I take it extremely seriously. But I did think that I might be allowed to have a life, too.
You're a serving officer, Charles, and you're about to go to sea. Even if you were to find the girl of your dreams tomorrow, how could you possibly ask her to commit herself till you're back on terra firma for good?
Perhaps she'll wait for me. I can't bear it.
It's only 8 months. Fly by.
I'll write to you every day.
I'd like that.
Will you miss me?
Of course I will.
It's awful.
It's good, Charles. It means you'll be 8 months older by the end of it. It's what you need, a few more years under your belt. Turn the boy prince into a man.
Dear Gladys,
Fred is being forced to become a man rather more quickly than he might have wished. Mama's insistence that I should be treated just like any other junior officer is, I'm sure, doing wonders for my moral fibre and giving me immense understanding and sympathy for my fellow man. But I long to wake up and find you lying next to me, with that wonderful welcoming smile that makes me feel loved and wanted.
Dear Fred, your letters are sweet. I miss you too, but we must both try to enjoy ourselves and not be too sad we're apart. Never forget, life is for living. We only get one chance. My philosophy, if I can call it that, is that we really ought to grab what comes along before it's too late. Does that sound horribly selfish? I don't mean it to. But life's awfully fragile. Who knows what tomorrow might bring? Your loving, but not very bright, Gladys.
In Germany. I missed him.
For heaven's sake. He'll put you in the tower or something.
I'm only being friendly. God, it's not the Dark Ages, you know.
So, are you back for good then?
Evidently.
What exactly are you trying to do, Andrew?
How do you mean?
I just wondered which royal bed you're really trying to get into.
What a terrible thing to say. Since you ask, I am a little curious. You was mentioned flattered. Your brother should muscle in on my territory.
You still regard her as your territory.
Camilla and I, we go back a long way.
Extraordinary how a bit of competition focuses the mind. Clever old Camilla.
Fred is extraordinarily depressed and homesick and generally ghastly today. The announcement of Anne's engagement to that dreary chap, Phillips, made me realize just how few people one has in life one's ever really close to. Of course, I think she's making an appalling mistake, but the point is she'll no longer be there for me like she used to be. So there's only Uncle Dickie. And you. And you seem more and more of a fantasy, a brief and wonderful dream I had. Is that what you are, Camilla? At the moment, the only silver lining I can see is the few days I have lined up in Ireland with Uncle Dickie. The castle's rather cosy, really. Uncle Dickie says he always feels more relaxed there than anywhere in the world. Perhaps I shall take you to Cassibourne one day. Would you like that,
Camilla?
So what do you think about Anne's news?
Oh, I'm delighted for her. Come on. Good chap, I'm sure. Not a Catholic, anyway.
You don't think it puts more pressure on me to do the decent thing, I mean?
Why should it?
Well, because she's my younger sister and she's got off the mark before me.
Oh.
Charles! Grandpapa! Just arrived. They never leave you alone, do they?
Thank you, Amanda. No, they really don't.
So they're a pretty girl, aren't she? Just like her mother was at her age. Just give her a few more years. Keep your options open. No hurry, is there? What is it?
Camilla tells me she's getting engaged to Parker Bowles. They're planning to marry in July.
Sorry.
Strange burning smell from the kitchen.
Oh, shit.
I can see your knickers, darling.
Lucky you.
Aren't you going to change into frock for Charles?
Oh, God, no. Charles won't mind.
Anyone else?
I'm absolutely stuffed. Come on, Toster.
Oh, good God, don't waste it on the dogs.
Good boy.
Mama's on an economy drive. I could take it home for summer.
You poor thing.
We're saving on water and heating, too.
Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night in a cold sweat thinking I'm still at Gordonston. Ghastly thought.
We've got some news for you, Charles.
I'm pregnant.
Congratulations. Both of you. Marvellous news. Well done. I intend on taking my duties as Godfather extremely seriously.
Really is an honor, sir. Thank you.
Well, that settles it.
What settles it?
She has a family now. A family and a life of her own.
Perhaps it's time you did.
Name, Fiona.
Thank you, sir.
You don't need to call me sir. Not now. So what do your friends call you? Do they have a special name for you?
Well, some people call me Yum Yum.
You certainly are jolly well put together, Yum Yum.
Thank you, sir.
Fancy hair as a sister-in-law.
She did seem to rather resent me spending so much time fishing. After that, it got even worse. I don't think she even liked Balmoral very much.
How could you not like Balmoral? It's the best place on earth.
Perhaps not if one's an enthusiastic part of swinging London. You don't mind me telephoning you. I know I shouldn't.
Why shouldn't you?
Well, because of...
I'd be really offended if you didn't.
You mean that?
Don't be so bloody silly. Of course I do.
So, when are you going to invite us up again? Visit's long overdue, I'd say.
Good shot, Charles. I hear you say you're off to London tonight.
Right, sir. Have to be with the regiment all week. Tough on Camilla, of course. Still, she prefers it in the country. Never has been one for gossiping with the officers' wives. Much for staying at home with Tom and the dogs.
I suggested she travel down with me tomorrow. Do you mind?
Good heavens, yeah.
You tell me if you did.
It's not natural. Besides, sometimes think I'm not quite as good a husband as I might be. I mean, having to be up in town such a lot. It's good for a deaf company. Stops me feeling guilty. But I very much appreciate you asking, Charles.
So how are things on the sex front? Oh dear, poor Charles.
You see, the thing is, it's not the actual sex itself. It's afterwards.
How do you mean afterwards?
Well, not before, sometimes. It's the appalling effort of having to have a conversation with someone has nothing in common with, not even a sense of humour. The terrible thing is, I can't talk to anyone like I can talk to you. I haven't met anyone, even after all this time.
What about the foreign girl? Bloody gorgeous by the sounds of it. What happened to her?
Oh, God. No, see, that's exactly it. We went to bed, taken off our things, and I just started making love to her. Do you mind awfully if I talk to you like this?
Go on.
Well, we just started to get down to it, and she suddenly says, "What shall I call you, Sir or Charles?" So I said, "Call me Arthur."
You didn't say that.
I did.
Oh, God.
You see, that's exactly it. She didn't find it funny, but you do. No hope, is there? No bloody hope at all.
A lot of photographs of suitable young women, most of whom are completely unsuitable. Prince stranded between altar and abyss.
Yes, I saw it. Rather melodramatic, I thought. Personally, I find the idea of marrying the wrong woman and enduring 50 years of misery far more disturbing than still being a bachelor at 30.
Well, papers are only reflecting mood of the country, Charles.
Or do they create it?
Either way, the country is determined you should find a bride. A mistress is no substitute for a wife, Charles.
I don't have a mistress. Camilla is not my mistress. She's my friend, my very good friend, and that's all, unfortunately. Besides, she's just had a baby, for heaven's sake.
The pressure's only going to get worse, you know.
Do you think I should pursue matters with Amanda? Tell me if you do.
Well, up to you, of course, but, well, she talks about you all the time, and in the most glowing terms. And your father's absolutely right. Nothing would give me greater pleasure than to see you and Amanda married. Good heavens, why wouldn't it? Both my favourite young people on the throne of England. But then I always was a selfish old bastard.
Seems our mutual grandfather harbours a certain romantic vision.
You mean you and me?
Please talk to you about it.
He really does mean well, doesn't he? For both of us.
Yes, he does. He really does.
What exactly did you expect her to say?
I don't know, something a bit more explicit. A little hint as to whether or not I was wasting my time entirely.
You're the Prince of Wales, darling. Even modern young girls like Amanda are going to be pretty careful what they say to you.
You think that's it? I just assumed she found me hideous and repugnant. Do you mind if I stay? I shan't impose on your dinner party. Just the thought of driving back home to a lot more heavy-handed nudge-nudge remarks about clever old Anne and her wonderful baby.
We'd be delighted, Charles, of course.
I'll make you some beans on toast.
A wonderful wife, Andrew.
Haven't I?
I wonder if Gavno's need a heavy bed license to drive one of these.
We have to put our plates up.
Yeah, then find someone who's experienced.
I think it's the most disgusting contraption I've ever seen. It undulates.
Party.
Great fun.
Where's Andrew? Has he gone to bed?
Had to go back to London.
Do you mind me asking how you cope?
I cope because he's my husband and I love him. And he loves me. And of course there's Tom.
Do you really love him?
Of course I bloody do. I know he sleeps with other women. But lots of my friends have marriages like that. God, I think I'm a bit pissed, actually. What we have is important too, Charles.
Certainly is for me.
No, but for me too, I mean. In fact, it seems to have become more and more important. Which really is a bit tricky.
Not necessarily.
That would make it even trickier. You know it would. I'm going to bed.
I have something to ask you, Amanda. Correct me if I'm wrong, but we do seem to get along rather well. But I'd be dishonest if I didn't tell you my frank opinion, which is that marriage to the heir to the throne is a terrible burden which brings with it little but sacrifice and loss of freedom. On the other hand, perhaps a second cousin might approach it positively, with a willingness to accept that burden. What I'm saying is, will you marry me, Amanda?
I really like you, Charles. I like being with you such a lot. I did wonder if this might happen. But I was enjoying myself too much to say anything. I feel about you like a brother. An older brother. Which isn't a very good starting point for married life, is it?
Sir, I told you I didn't want to be interrupted.
Yes, sir, but it's Mrs. Parker Bowles, sir. Line one, sir.
I'm so sorry to hear about Amanda. I got your message last night that Andrew was here. Silly girl.
I hope you're not feeling too horribly rejected, Charles.
No.
What is it?
It's Uncle Dickie. He's been killed. Been blown up by the IRA. He's boat.
Come down here. Now, darling, please.
Police in the Irish Republic have reported that Lord Mountbatten has been killed in an explosion in his boat off the coast of Ireland.
He was a war hero. He survived two world wars. He's not the sort to be beaten by a few mad drunken.
Bloody Irishman!
I shouldn't have intruded on you like this, I'm sorry.
I asked you to.
I keep trying to tell myself that I was lucky to have him so long. I gained so much from him. He's irreplaceable.
I understand.
You always do.
They that go down to the sea in ships and occupy their business in great waters. For at his word the stormy wind arises, which lifteth up the waves thereon. They are carried up to the heavens and down again to the deep. Their soul melteth away because of the trouble.
Couldn't have managed without you. As I was walking up the aisle, I had to make myself think of you, not him.
I found it jolly difficult myself.
I can't endure it without you. Any of it. Tried, but I can't. You should leave, Andrew. Divorce him. Marry me. Don't laugh at me, please.
I'm not laughing at you.
I love you and I want to marry you. I've never loved anyone else and I'm damn sure I never will now.
It's not possible. You know it's not.
Anything is possible. One just has to make it possible.
You'll be forced to give up your throne. Your whole family would hate you. You'd end up like the Duke of Windsor, forced to live on some godforsaken island. Completely pointless existence. I'll be branded a calculating old bitch like the poor old Duchess.
It's just so hard, it really is.
Doesn't have to be. You know I love you and I'm here for you and I always will be here.
That's what Uncle Dickie said.
Yes, but I will be. So long as the fags don't get me or I fall off a bloody horse and break my neck. You'll always be number one. I promise you.
Do you mean it?
Yes, Fred, I do.
Now, Gladys, I think I'm beginning to feel a little better.
Now, before we get carried away, something I want to discuss with you.
What is it?
I'm going to find you a wife. Well, you haven't been much good at it. The family hasn't been much cop either. At least this way I get to find out who the competition is. You sure about Princess Caroline?
Yes, we've already met. She irritated me enormously and I believe I bored her to death.
But she's European and a princess. Couldn't you put up with just a tiny bit of irritation? It's even remotely possible she's a virgin.
Frankly, I think I'm even less likely to end up marrying her than Susan George.
We're talking innocent young virgins, Charles, not past shags. What about someone your mother would like to meet?
Anna, this is my sister Anne.
How do you do?
Anna is an excellent horsewoman. We met on the hunting field.
It's extraordinary how horses bring people together. Charles always said that I couldn't marry my horse, so I married Mark. Actually, I think he might be right.
Oh, excuse me.
Of course.
She's a very old friend.
Evidently.
Would you like to dance?
No, thank you. No one treats me like that, not even you. Don't ever, ever ignore me like that again. All right?
Extraordinary.
Ignoring one's girlfriend and dancing with one's mistress all evening is a trifle tactless, Charles. Perhaps I should keep a rather lower profile.
I'd be upset. A part of my life, whoever I marry, is going to have to accept it.
I think they might just find that a little difficult. Don't worry. We'll find someone. Do you know anyone, Anne? Any nice, sweet virgins?
Grandmama did mention someone. Lady Fairmoy's granddaughter. Of course, Charles isn't keen. What a surprise.
No, she's 19. Just imagine it. She's far too young. She'd be so boring.
I don't know. Someone not too set in her ways. Someone you could mould a little, darling. Sounds rather promising. Did the girl have a name?
Diana, one of the Spencer girls.
Didn't you go out with her sister?
Sarah, yes. Not much for success.
But did you, you know?
No, we didn't.
Well, that's relief, isn't it? If you know what I mean.
Yes. It is, rather. Are you really 19? God, you look even younger.
Only just 19, sir. It's my birthday a couple of weeks ago.
Really? Well, then. Happy birthday, then.
Thank you. I hope you don't mind me saying something, sir. Just, I saw you on television at your Uncle Mountbatten's funeral last year. I thought you looked so sad walking up the aisle. It was the most tragic thing I've ever seen. My heart bled for you. I thought, it's wrong. You're so lonely. With somebody to look after you.
What a very sweet thing to say. Thank you. Drive take?
20 minutes. I'll get it down to 15, but I got bloody lost.
I have infinite faith.
God, it's going to be marvellous, isn't it? Proper place of your own. One you've actually chosen. I knew it was right the second I saw it.
Marvellous thing is you're so near. Can't imagine a sexier neighbour.
Not in front of the workers, darling. I've spoken to a few chums about the Spencer girl.
Mm.
Brilliant with children, apparently. Definitely no past.
Well, there's a miracle.
Absolutely. All in all, sounds perfectly sweet.
I got that impression myself.
Would you like me to vet her for you, darling?
I think I would, yes. If you don't mind.
Charles loves the country. Much happier outdoors than indoors. Really think you could deal with that, do you? Well,
of course.
Likes nothing better than spending all day on his own, traipsing through the country, just him and his dogs. Sometimes they've had to send out search parties.
I just admire him so much. He has so much responsibility. A man like that needs to unwind. One would just have to respect that.
Do you hunt?
Sorry?
Do you hunt?
No. No, I don't. I don't think I could manage that, actually. Why? Should I, do you think?
Not at all.
Don't
Don't worry. After all, you can't be good at everything, can you?
I really feel one could do something here. Put one's mark upon it.
The garden could be marvellous.
Exactly. As for the farm, it's 340 acres, Andrew. One might be able to make it commercially viable, just about. Borrow a couple of cows from Windsor, provide one's own milk. Just imagine.
Marvellous idea, yes.
What about indoors, Charles? How are the plans for the decorations coming?
What decorations?
Well, it's going to need a major overhaul. I mean, 8 bedrooms and 4 receptions. It is 4, isn't it? Of course, it'll need someone to organise it. Perhaps Diana might like to help.
Yes. What an excellent idea. But only if you've got the time, of course. You're probably far too busy with your kindergarten and things.
No, I'd be honoured, sir, if you're sure you'd want me to.
Well, undertaking such a major operation may prove rather excessive.
You'll just have to get used to Charles. What he really means is he'd love you to.
I think the pool might go there. And the fruit trees there, vegetable garden there. One would have to create paths and hedges, of course. My ultimate dream is to combine the wildness of nature with a definite formality of design, both in the same garden. Yin and yang, as it were.
Sounds wonderful, sir. It's a really beautiful place. Did Mrs. Parker Bowles help you choose it?
She did offer a bit of advice, yes. She's a very good friend, my oldest friend, in fact. And she lives just up the road.
That kind of her.
Yes. Wasn't it?
Can I ask you something else, sir?
Yes.
If you ever did have a wife, just supposing I mean, do you think you'd still be just as good friends with Mrs. Parker Bowles?
Why do you ask?
I just wondered.
Well, perhaps not quite as good friends, no.
Thank you.
What do you mean, thank you?
Nothing, really, sir.
Come on then, darling, let's go, shall we? Camilla? Are you bored? Terribly nice. She really seems to adore me.
Well, that always helps.
She's also horribly young. We have nothing whatsoever to talk about. Sometimes I look at her and she doesn't seem old enough to be out of school, let alone married.
I'm sure you can find things to talk about, darling. Perhaps you're just not trying hard enough.
You don't know how hard I've tried. The other day she asked me if I liked the police. Rather peculiar question, I thought. Then she told me about some chap named Sting, and I finally knew what she was talking about. It's impossible. They inhabit entirely different universes.
She's a delightful girl, darling. She gets prettier by the day. It alarms me sometimes. Anyway, He's going to produce beautiful children and be a wonderful mother. Just trust me, darling. I love you and I'm here for you. Always and always. All the listening and the talking you could possibly need.
So you really, seriously think I should?
You know I do, darling.
HRH is very fond of my wife. It appears that she is very fond of him.
Terribly sorry, old chap.
Don't be sorry. It's an honour. It's called laying down your wife for your country. It's the least I can do, after all.
Can you find the words to describe how you feel today?
Difficult to find words in a way, isn't it, really? Just delighted and happy. I'm amazed she's been brave enough to take me on.
I suppose you're in love?
Of course.
Whatever in love means, you'll have to put your own interpretation on that.
Obviously means you're two very happy people.
Yes, we are.
As you can see.
The world has clearly gone insane.
Just keep your pecker up, Charles. Only a few more days.
And then?
Then, all the fun and romance will be over. And you'll be just another boring married couple.
This whole thing's disastrously out of control. What should I do?
Well, it's a bit late to cut and run. The cathedral's already booked. Mama sent out 2,500 invitations. There's nothing you can do, Charles. Just close your eyes, think of England.
How bizarre the whole world has fallen so deeply in love with my sweet little fiancé. One wonders what they would think if they saw her in her less sweet and reasonable moments.
Some people might say she's had good reason to be provoked.
They'd be wrong. And once I'm married, I fully intend to honour my marriage vows. And be a loyal and faithful husband.
Well, Andrew will be pleased.
Not necessarily. My absence will mean that he has to take his marriage duties considerably more seriously.
Oh dear. Still, we all have to play the hand we're dealt, don't we?
Why can't you be honest with me?
I am being honest with you. It's for Camilla. I said it was for Camilla.
I know it's for Camilla. It says so on the package, but what do G and F stand for?
Please don't shout. There's really no need.
Then tell me!
I really don't have to tell you everything, Diana.
Yes, you do! We're getting married!
You see, we have very different ideas about marriage. I'm afraid I don't accept that marriage means I have to sacrifice every last little vestige of privacy.
Ridiculous! I would have to put up with the most awful invasions of privacy, and you just sail on regardless. Do you have any idea what I've been through?
We've all had to put up with intrusions into our privacy recently, God knows.
I don't mean the press. I'm talking about rather more intimate things. About having to prove to the bloody doctor that I've kept myself neat and tidy for you. If I could put up with that, you would tell me what G and F stands for!
It's from the Goon Show. Gladys and Fred, they're two characters in the Goon Show. They're just nicknames Camilla and I have for one another. The sort of thing you have between friends, you know? Perfectly innocent, you see.
Right, so What was the point in buying her a gold bracelet and having it engraved and sending it to her now?
To thank her.
To thank her for what?
Because she's an intimate and dear friend, and she's always been there for me, even through my most difficult times.
It's inappropriate, Charles.
How dare you tell me what's inappropriate?
I don't want you to see her again.
No one tells me who I can and cannot see.
When did you talk to her last?
Did you hear what I said? I refuse to be cross-questioned like this. It's intolerable.
Then promise me you won't see her again, that's all.
Don't be absurd. The Parker Bowles is a part of our set. It's inevitable that we continue to see them.
If you love me at all, you've got to promise me.
Give me the bracelet.
I won't go through with it. If you don't promise me, I'll cancel the wedding. I mean it.
Naturally, my relationship with Camilla will change after we're married. I thought I made that quite clear.
Charles!
I need to see you.
Tonight?
No, now. Have you got the key?
I get it. Will they mind us using it?
No, I'm sure they won't mind us using it.
Again?
Tell them it's the last time, we will.
Lovely.
Good.
Does it really have to be the last time?
God, don't imagine I want it to be.
No, I know. You're quite right. So, how is the bride to be?
It's like walking on glass. One has to tread ever so bloody carefully. Whatever it is that she needs, I certainly don't seem to be giving it.
I'm sure you are, darling.
Unfortunately not. Very clearly not.
I can't imagine how you've put up with it these last few months. The whole thing, I mean. Especially being on show like that.
Put up with it by thinking of you.
You're so brave. I'm so proud of you. I'd never have survived for 5 seconds.
I sometimes think I shan't either. Don't get me wrong, I'm not going to bottle it. It's far too late for that. Oh, God. Just imagine if I did.
You'll be fine, darling. Just wait till you're married. In fact, I know exactly what's going to happen. You're going to go off on your honeymoon. And you're going to fall head over heels for her. You won't be able to get enough of her, and you'll end up besotted, just like the rest of the world. You won't be interested anymore in your frousty old ex-mistress. Not if she came begging, probably.
Thing is, you're the only woman I've ever really loved in my life. So no one else could ever take your place. Which is appalling bad luck for Diana. Or anyone else, for that matter.
What are we getting in a state about? Really, this is what we always knew would happen.
Do you know what Father said? He'd give it 5 years. If it
doesn't work out, then take alternative measures.
Of course it'll work. You've got to give it a chance, darling.
I know.
More than a chance. It can't be allowed not to work.
No. A far, far better thing. Who said that? Was it Tennyson or Shakespeare?
God knows. I thought it was Eccles or Bluebottle. I wish I was a literary genius like you, darling. Do you know me? I had trouble getting through Black Beauty.
You are a genius.
No, I'm not. I'm really very stupid, you know I am. In fact, I've never achieved anything in my whole life. Except for loving you, I suppose.
What a very great achievement.
Is it?
Of course. What greater achievement could anyone possibly wish for in life?
Easier than falling off a chair, darling. Really.
Jason gets a shock encounter when he investigates the death of a gigolo. A Touch of Frost, that's Tuesday at 10. Coming next, it's a dazzling encounter of the Queen's 40th anniversary in Days of Majesty.